Father, I pray and thank you for this morning, Father, for the seven of us that has gathered, Father, even as it is the seventh time that we gather together as a body. I thank you for seven people that you have brought, Father. I pray you will think through my mind, speak through my vocal cords. This will be our prayer to you, Father, and you from heaven will hear and answer. Give us your expected aim. In Jesus Christ's name we ask, Lord. I want to share a short word this morning. It's taken from the book of Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 5. Paul wrote more than 20 epistles, as you know. I'm not going to name them. But I think of all the epistles, the one to Ephesus is the one that gives our most attention. Because there he prayed for 3 years and 6 months with much tears for those people. And I think he summed up everything about the church of Ephesus and every other church in just one sentence in chapter 4 and verse 5. It says, one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. Now, why did he say that? Because we all know that we can have only one Lord. Bible says, thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image, or any image that is sufficient in the earth beneath, or in the water below the earth. That's why when God accosted Paul on the road to Damascus, said, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? What did he say? Who art thou? Lord! He didn't know the Lord that was persecuting. That Lord was none other than Jesus Christ. And I thank God for Paul, who found that Lord on the road to Damascus, and who went all the way from there to preach the gospel in the synagogues, come back to Jerusalem, join himself with the apostles, and even for Barnabas, who went with him when no one else went with him. Today, how many people does he want to go here, but there is no one to go with us? We don't know why. But maybe today when God wants us, like he wanted John Mark, and when John Mark didn't come, God found another Silas to go with him. But later Paul said, John Mark is important for me. Bring Mark to me. And I praise God that Mark was brought. And God, thank God, made him write the gospel according to St. Mark. So when we look at Paul, he says, one Lord, one faith. Why did he say one faith? Because in Luke chapter 18 and verse 8, what does it say? When the Son of Man cometh, will he find faith? That's why Paul, as he said in his own words, preached the unadulterated gospel. He preached it without fear of any man. Wherever he did, he preached the whole counsel of God. And wherever we go, we are also called to preach the whole counsel of God. And praise God for Paul, who took that faith and took it to Ephesus, to Philippi, and to all the other places in Colossae, and to Thessalonica, and wherever he went. And I praise God today, that is the faith that we are also teaching. I want to praise and thank God that when we came to serve the Lord, we closed up all our bank accounts and trusted only one bank, the Bank of Heaven. And that bank has never let us down, not even unto today. I want to thank and praise God. Because God is a God who teaches us that we must have one Lord and one faith and one baptism. Glad all the people here have taken baptism by immersion. But that alone is not enough. Paul came to Jesus and said, have you received the Holy Ghost since you believe? What is the Holy Ghost? When do you receive the Holy Ghost? Only when you speak in an unknown tongue. And I think we all do that. And we all have today emboldened on that task. Now why am I saying all this? To only make us aware that Jesus is coming soon. And his coming is much sooner than the dawn. As the Lord said this morning, he is coming downwards, we have to go upwards. And therefore this morning, I want you to know that like the eagle, what must we do? We must look up. But what must we look up and do? We must mount up with wings as eagle. Other birds fly, eagles don't fly. They just mount up. With every problem that comes in the house, from every quarter, from father, from mother, from brother, from sister. What do? We just go up and up and up and up and up and up and up. Suddenly the eagle builds its nest on a very high rock. Why does he do that? So that the enemy can't get to him. But the enemy somehow other will come. Like in the Garden of Eden, it came to Adam and Eve when they were in the wrong place. So who is that enemy, Nisha? The snake. The snake can go up the rock this way, that way, that way, this way, come there to catch and to steal the little eaglets. But praise God for the eagle who teaches us a lesson on how to destroy the enemy. If the eagle catches that snake, one, it will take that snake and with its beak, fortify it, pick it into pieces, that there will be nothing left other than the carcass of that snake. What does that teach us, Lalendra? That when the devil comes, we peck at him with the word of God until he goes. He comes again and we say, it is written. And again he comes, we will say, it is written. And he will flee. And then for a time he will not come. And angels will come and minister. The other way he deals with the snake is he catches it with its claws, takes it and goes on the sea. And from there drops it on a big rock. And it crashes down there. And it breaks into smithereens and is destroyed. So in other words, today, give your problem to the Lord. And he will take it. He will smash it. He will destroy it. And I want to praise and thank God for the eagle. The eagle, when it mates, mates in the air. But the eagle has mating in the air. One eagle mating. It's a beautiful sight to see. I've seen it on a film. I don't think you will see it here because we have no eagles. But it's a wonderful, wonderful sight. Finally and lastly, when the eagle dies, it dies looking at the sun. When the eagle flies also, it flies looking at the sun. Why at the sun? Because Jesus is the Son of Righteousness, S-U-N. The Son of Righteousness. So when he dies also, he dies looking at the sun and says, I am going to a far, far better place. Though I cannot come back to you, you can come to me. That is our hope. That's why at Christian services we say, death is not the end. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? And like the eagle, we can go back to our Maker in great resplendent joy, saying, I have preached the unquenchable riches of God. I have preached one Lord, one faith, one baptism, and now I come to take my place there. Learn to help the needy, the orphans, the widows, the fatherless. So therefore this day, learn to minister to the orphans, to the fathers, to the widows, and God will be happy. Then we can say, I have run the race, I have fought the good fight, and I have kept the faith. One Lord, one faith, one baptism. Glory be to God. Amen. Father, we thank you for this morning. We thank you, Lord, for another morning that you have given us. We thank you, Lord, for Pastor Chandru's birthday today. And we thank you for this great day, which is the Lord's Day, Father. Bless us together as seven, and make us a people going forward and not backward, even as we commit this morning and everyone gathered here. Into no better hands than yours, I pray. In Yeshua HaMashiach's name we ask, Lord.
Amen. Amen.